Kurt has asked me to read for us. It just really pleases me. And each time I say to myself, self, just do the assignment, don't talk. And I can't help it. And two things came up today already that I want to share with you. He was talking about accidents happen for a reason. Trying to wrap my head around that, so I'm going to call mine an incident. I'm not having a relapse on my illness of last year. Y'all helped me work through that. But I had an incident this week where I started falling, trying to catch myself. I broke a toe and pulled a hamstring. And if you've ever done that, you know how painful that can be. So many times in life I've fallen on my face, but I didn't want to do that in front of all of you as my witnesses today. So this is a little security that helps support that toe. Kurt said something already this morning too that made me think about a little funny I want to share with you. He talked about how we have a good feeling at Christmas. I've shared with you that I'm a kid at heart, and I learned that if you lose the child in yourself, you lose your creativity. I'm in a business that I have to stay as creative as I can, and I love decorating the salon at Christmas time, and I have two pillars. We have two little mascots at the shop, and I put a pillow in each of their hands, and one says, Santa, would you describe good? And then the other one says, be naughty and save Santa for good. I try to keep my head above water and stay somewhere in between there, and I'm trying to do that. Want to do another little commercial, if I may. Kurt has invited you to come up here in this spot, and I call it a warm fuzzy. Every time he does, I get this warm fuzzy. And when one of you, my friends, comes up, I get a warm fuzzy. And when someone new comes up, I get two warm fuzzies. So on his behalf, because he won't keep asking and asking, but I'll do it for him. If you want to do this, and I promise you, you'll be rewarded for it, please come forward. Kurt is my go-to person when I need pronunciations of assignments that he's given me. He had his chauffeur's cap on this morning, couldn't find him. He was out picking up people, which I think is admirable, but that's maybe a job we should help him do. So I went to another one of my go-to people, who happens to be another one of my theater friends, to pronounce a word. And he said, Jim, you're in theater. You just smooth over the word and don't think you know what you're talking about. So my assignment, one last little comment. As I was reading this, and just see if you pick up on it, I think when Kurt teaches me and gives me the right interpretation of this scripture, I'll have a different slant on it. But there's one phrase in here, one verse that I thought, even God has a sense of humor. So, Zephanianh, something like that, anyway. Chapter 3, 14 through 20, the message. And in this message, every time he assigned me something, I think, boy, this is talking to you. But I've learned about the Bible, and I'm not a scholar. But I learned something so good every time, and then it verifies the fact why it's the number one bestseller. But I got a real message in this. If I've interpreted right, and I think across the board, it's going to give you a message too. You know, I lost a big point I was going to say. I did that last time. I lost my thought. But this has been a week of incidents for me. I had the fall, and so I've been struggling with that. And then this morning, I was trying to get dressed to come here, and I pulled this jacket out that I haven't worn since last fall, and it shrunk. And then I got the shirt ready, and a button was missing. And I thought, you know what? I've ended up in a church home. It didn't matter what you look like. I'm in the image business, and every other day of the week I have to worry about helping people look good and feel good about themselves. But in this place, it doesn't matter what you look like, and you're forgiven if you don't act right sometimes. That happens. So, chapter 3, 14 through 20, the message. So sing, daughter Zion, raise the rafters, Israel. Daughter Jerusalem, be happy, celebrate. God has reversed his judgments against you and sent your enemies off chasing their tails. From now on, God is Israel's king in charge at the center. There's nothing to fear from evil ever again. God is present among you. Jerusalem will be told, don't be afraid. Dear Zion, don't despair. Your God is present among you, a strong warrior there to save you. Happy to have you back, he'll calm you with his love and delight you with his songs. The accumulated sorrows of your exile will dissipate. I, your God, will get rid of them for you. You've carried those burdens long enough. At the same time, I'll get rid of all those who've made your life miserable. I'll heal the maimed. I'll bring home the homeless. In the very countries where they were hated, they will be venerated. On Judgment Day, I'll bring you back home, a great family gathering. You'll be famous and honored all over the world. You'll see it with your own eyes, all those painful partings turned into reunions. God's promise. This is the word of the Lord, and I can't wait for him to tell us more about this.